Let's take it up one more time. Every praise, good evening and welcome. The time is 5:30 here on the East Coast. I want to welcome you to your worship show. Wherever you are listening from, if you are on sonicradio.com, I welcome you if you are on YouTube. I welcome you if you are listening on our mobile apps, iTunes. Watching me on Facebook, I want to welcome you tonight. This is the day that the Lord has made. I'm so excited for another day. God has brought us into His presence. I don't know about you, but God is so good. He's been so good. You know, we say that over and over again, and some of us it becomes a cliche, meaning it's just something, oh, it's acceptable. No, God is good. God watches for His word to perform. He's great I am. There is none like Him. Please do me a favor. Share on your timeline. Share with somebody. I welcome you, Reverend Dr. Joseph Rennie. God bless you. Oh my goodness, the Bernard Victory all the way from Ghana. God bless you. Thank you guys so much. Do me a favor, share in any group you are tonight. Share with a friend. Share with a loved one. God is going to move in our midst tonight. It's power and glory night. I want you to invite somebody tonight to do a worship show, whether you are on YouTube, whether you are on Facebook, wherever you are listening from tonight. Invite a friend. There is going to be a performance of the word of the Lord in our midst tonight. As we listen to worship music, as we listen to praise music, God is going to do something in your life. So stay tuned. We are listening to Dr. Kofi Thompson, Africa Rhythm Medley. Stay tuned now. Don't change that dial. Somebody want to put those hands together. There is none like our God. He's the Most High God. When Isaiah said, he said, in the same year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord lifted high. And since I saw the Lord and his train fill the tabernacle, God bless you all so much for joining. We want to give God praise and welcome each and every one of you, wherever you are listening from, on Sunlight Radio, if you are listening on YouTube, my cousin, Mrs. Carter, God bless you. Cousin Rosie, God bless you. Mary Queen, God bless you. Thank you for joining. If you are on YouTube, just let me know you are there. I will acknowledge you, share with somebody, invite them tonight. God is in the business of blessing. God is in the business of delivering. God is in the business of lifting you up tonight, Mr. Robinson Brown. And God bless you also, my esteemed you tonight. It's a power and glory night. That's what we have entitled tonight's show, Power and Glory. You see the demonstration of the power of God and the glory of God come upon your life. Please invite somebody to join tonight. Just share on your time that you see there's something about the word of God when you share it. It is the power of the Spirit and that will cause people to come and be attracted to it. Bible says when we lift him up, he will draw all men to him. So tonight, just share on your timeline, invite a friend, invite a loved one. We're going to lift up our voice and magnify the name of the Lord. Stay tuned now. This is Sunlight Radio. We'll listen to Dr. Kofi Thompson. Coming up right after him is Mr. Vachon Mitchell. I'm chasing after you. Tonight I pray that you tie your belt and tell the Lord that nothing will stop me. I'm chasing after the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Stay tuned now.
Enough to you, no matter what I do, 'cause tonight. Tonight we just want to chase after the Lord. We want to seek after His face. David said, where can I go from your presence, oh God? He said, if I go to the uttermost part of the earth, there you are with me. He said, if I go to the deepest most part, you are there. And God is watching over you. He's omnipresent. He's the great and mighty God. Tonight we want to chase after the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And the mighty one to save. I stay tuned tonight. Please don't change or die. I share with somebody. Invite somebody tonight. I say, Tune in to www.sunlightradio. If you're on Facebook, you can follow after me, Reverend Clarence D. Roberts. And tonight, if you're on YouTube, it's Sunlight Radio. I stay tuned tonight. God is up to something. Do not change that dial. We want to chase after the Lord. We want to see the provision hand of God. We want to see the peace of God rule and reign. And you are welcome, my sister, my own October born. And God bless you. God bless you. This is my boy. Thank you for joining. A woman of God, stay tuned now. Please share on your timeline tonight. I said it's power and glory. You're going to see the demonstration of the power of God. If you have a sickness, bring it tonight. If you need peace in your life, bring it tonight. At the sound of the voice of God, that there is going to be deliverance in your house, in your place of business, wherever you are. We're going to seek after the Lord tonight. I stay tuned, child of God. Don't you dare change that dial. We are just building up the atmosphere. Now is for sure teacher chasing after you. Stay tuned. To the name of the Lord. And this song says, I am under the canopy. I don't know where you want to be. But David said, I lift up my eyes in the 121st Psalm. He said, I lift up my eyes unto the hill. Where is my help coming from? My help coming from the Lord that made the heaven and the earth. Please identify yourself when you come. And Bernard Victory, God bless you. Thank you for listening all the way from Ghana. Stay tuned. Tonight we are under the canopy of the Almighty God. Man of God, Pastor Janine Zong from Liberia. You are welcome tonight. Tonight is power and glory night. Share with somebody. You're going to see the demonstration of the hand of God. I don't know what you need of God tonight, but God has an answer to every need that you have. Sister Cynthia, you are welcome. God bless you all so much. Please share with somebody on your timeline and invite a friend, invite a loved one. Stay tuned now, Sunlight Radio. Who else do we have our confidence in but the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Who else that says His word will never fail, will go and accomplish the task and the purpose for which He sends it? It is Jehovah God, the awesome God, the great I am. There is none to compare to Him. Stay tuned tonight. I welcome you. Oh my God. I'm a prophetess. His grace is Kwashika Kavi. God bless you all so much. Stay tuned tonight. It's going to be a power and packed night. God is going to move in the midst of His people. I sense it already. Stay tuned now. We are under the canopy of the Almighty God. Welcome once again, this is Pastor Clarence. This is a song I just discovered. Pastor Edwin Darcy. We've come this far by grace. Welcome Sister Kezia. Please stay tuned tonight. Don't you change your dial. Pastor Clarence. can begin to decree and declare that you will make it. You've come this far. Throughout the year, God is taking you through. Don't change the dial. You can prophesy to yourself that you have made it. Pastor Clarence, stay tuned now. We've already made it thus far. You will make it. God is good. For the one child of God, I just want this new song, so get your dancing shoe on.
Somebody also stand to their feet.
From South Africa, God walk with us.
My God,
protect God, guide your people.
In the name of the Lord Jesus,
come on somebody begin to put those hands together, begin to praise the Lord.
Let me give you some time to just bless the Lord.
Do your own dance as you want. Our God is good.
He will protect you, he will guide you, he will shield you.
So long as you are in divine alignment with the plans and the purpose of God, he has an obligation to watch over his word to perform for your life.
Stay tuned tonight.
This is power and glory of the night.
Oh my God.
Somebody needs to stand on their feet and do their own dance. I'm constrained in the studio a little bit. We're going to reconfigure everything now. Somebody said they want to see me moving. Come on, just the up part now. Who's the up part?
We give you God praise.
He's ready.
Come on.
Somebody need to move.
I see your move.
I like those moves.
God bless you all tonight.
This is Sunlight Radio.
This is Throne Worship Show.
And we give you God praise.
And tonight we're going to lift up prayer for the nation of Ghana.
Ghana is going to have elections tomorrow. At the seventh day of this month, we're going to lift up prayer for Liberia. We have an election coming up Tuesday as well. We are praying that the peace of God will rule and reign in both nations. And that God will watch over His word to perform. Bible says, my peace I give to you. Not like any man, woman, nothing can get the peace that God will give unto you. When God blesses you, He gives you the peace that you will not be disturbed. So we will lift up prayer for both nations. We lift up prayer for America doing the elections. We do that for Ghana. We do that for Liberia tonight. So you want to join me tonight? This night is called. Power and glory, welcome to the Yellow Rappers. Stay tuned now.
It's Chai Keys on the beat.
Are you ready now?
This is one of my favorite songs. This is Jehovah Obadu, Ephesians 2:20.
God is able to do exceedingly abundantly far above all that you ask or think.
This is from my friend, Pastor Moses Warrior, who was on with us last week.
We want to express thanks to all of you that donated to the cause that he is representing in Liberia, the Albino Society.
God bless you. May God overdo for you. Whatever you are looking for, that job, you will own the company. If you are looking for healing, I pray that God will restore your health tonight.
Stay tuned.
This is Jehovah Obadu, God Obadu. His love will supersede all your expectations. Stay tuned tonight.
Personal. See the testimony. You get the glory. You get the honor when everything, yeah. You love the personal. See the testimony. You get the glory. You get the honor when everything. Oh, 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 oh.
How many of you tonight believe that God is too good? Imagine where you were a couple of months ago, all locked in, can't go out, so afraid. You are still here. Stay tuned. God told Job, he said, you shall decree a thing, it will be established. Now you're going to decree your tomorrow. I hope you know the song. my tomorrow must be greater. I'm prophesying into the day, the week, the end of the month. Stay tuned. Sunlight Radio, Tune Room Worship Show. We are lifting up now. Beloved, you are welcome. This is Pastor Clarence. Mr. Jonathan Lamptey, Dr. Love himself, wishing Mrs. Faustina Lamptey a happy birthday. God bless you, my sister. I pray that may the Lord God bring you into a season of abundance, a season where favor will become your middle name, your first name, and your last name. God bless you so much. It's been a long time. We have fellowship. Stay tuned. Sister Akosia, you are welcome tonight. Stay tuned. Don't change your dial. Invite somebody. When God told Job that you can decree a thing and it will be established, he was giving him the authority to speak and act like a God. You are made in the image and likeness of Elohim. My children behave after me. They do things I do. Both of my kids are kind of different, but you can look at their lives and see that they are children of Clarence DeMarcus Roberts because of the way they act, the way they behave. If you are a child of the Most High God, if you have confessed with your lips the Lord Jesus and Christ has adopted you into his kingdom, you can begin to decree things that tomorrow, Lord, I pray that when I go to work, the supervisor that has been causing me trouble, I'm speaking, I'm rearranging that, Lord, let him be transferred, let her be transferred. I'm speaking to the sickness. Your word says, by your stripes I'm healed. You told Jeremiah said, he says, heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. David said in the 110th Psalm, that the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, bless the Lord and forget not his benefits. You want to speak and say one of the benefits, you say you heal me of all my disease. You want to lift your voice and begin to speak, decree and declare to whatever is ailing you and say by the voice of Jehovah, by the word of God that is supreme. The Bible says heaven and earth will pass away, but his word, how can his word pass away if he is the word? John tells us that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He said that same God, he was in the beginning, he became flesh, he dwelt among you and I. So if you speak the Word, tonight there's power and glory night. Oh, don't let me get into the Word yet. Stay tuned, child of God. Share with somebody. Your tomorrow will be greater. Coming up right after this, it's a new son of mine in Ghana. Ancient of Days, Brenna Victory. Stay tuned, Bernard. I love this song that you made. He is the Ancient of Days. Can I change? Stay tuned. God bless you so much tonight for tuning in. This is from a wonderful brother I just came in contact with, Asian of Days, Bernard Victory. He's on Facebook right now listening. What up, Bernard? God bless you for releasing this awesome, making yourself available to the Lord. Asian of Days, let's listen. Right after that, we have another surprise music. I always bring surprise music. I just got to know about this yesterday, and I bring it, Overflow, Erama. Come on, Akosian. We're going to feature it, you know. Stay tuned. That is a fact by the word of the Lord. If you turn to Psalm 89, the Bible says something. Psalm 89, beginning at verse 34, it says, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the thing that is gone out of my lips. That's what the Bible says. He says, once have I sworn by the holiness that I will not lie unto David. He said, his seed shall endure forever, and his throne as the sun before me. He said, it shall be established forever as the moon and as the faithful witness in heaven. Bible says, my covenant I will not break. He's the covenant keeping God. He will not break what he said. He has spoken unto you. The Bible says, every word that proceeds out of the mouth of the Father, it will go and accomplish the task. Why? It is impossible for God to say A, and it comes back and says B. No, A means A, B means B. He's not a God that can change his mind. Number 23. So tonight, as you listen to this wonderful music, there's no one else like our God. From the beginning of the sun, from the beginning of the universe, there is no one else like our God. Stay tuned now. Right after this, it's a wonderful music, Overflow by Erama. Stay tuned. She's a wife of a friend. I want you to just listen and enjoy this wonderful music. We are getting ready to release the word of God, power and glory. Sister Lady Asiako, you are welcome tonight. beloved, we're getting to that point tonight. This is Franca. We had her on a couple of months ago. My God, says you are the pillar that holds my life. If you are resting on this rock, the immovable rock, the rock that is so stable that it is the one that upholds the earth, can I prophesy unto you that nothing will dissuade you, nothing will harm you, nothing will break through this barrier that God has around you, the hedge that he has built around you. Remember what the devil told God. He says, you have protected him that is of Job. God loves you so much that he told Jeremiah, I know every strand of hair on your head. You take time. Can you count it? The ones that you see are the gray ones. What about the darker ones? Can you count it? But Bible says, God knows. He can number them one by one. He can pick and say, this is number one. This is number two. That is the fine detail that God takes to protect you. He knows every strand of hair upon your life, on my life. He knows what you're going to go through tomorrow, what you're going to go through today. You think he didn't know COVID-19 was going to come, but child of God, even though COVID-19 was going to come, he had already made a way. If you read from Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, if it translated in the Hebrew language, God had already made a way that Christ was going to die for you and I. So have the confidence that God has you. You cannot fail right now. No. It is not possible. I want to encourage somebody tonight that many of us are going through this pandemic, and we are going through this pandemic, and you think that, oh my goodness, it's all over for me. But let me encourage you tonight, it is not all over. God is taking care of his people. God is watching over his word to perform for you and I. Our God that watches over you, he neither sleeps, neither he slumbers. I want to thank each and every one of you tonight who have tuned in to True Moon Worship Show. And I pray that as you have tuned in tonight, may the Lord also tune in to you and pay attention to your needs and your wants and your desires in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let's pray. Father, we thank you tonight. We magnify your name, for you are King of Kings. That is a fact. You are Lord of Lords. That is a fact. You are the one that keeps us in the palm of your hand. That is a fact. We give you the glory tonight. We pray that as we look at your word, Father, I pray that minister to somebody, visit somebody tonight, touch lives tonight, heal somebody tonight. Father, we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say me, amen. Thank you so much, beloved. Thank you for joining us. Like I said, we will pray for the nation of Ghana. So wherever you are, you want to join us. If you are hail from Ghana, whether you don't hail from Ghana, wherever country you are from, we're going to lift up that nation of Ghana. We're going to lift up Liberia. Ghana has its elections tomorrow. Liberia is doing an elections in the city of Monserrato, or the county of Monserrato. We want to lift up prayer for both nations. I am a child of Africa, of the world. I live in Ghana. I'm married to a Ghanaian, so I'm an adopted citizen of Ghana. So don't feel jealous of me. I'm originally from Liberia, but God is good. Welcome to each and every one of you, my wonderful minstrel, Helen Light. God bless you. I saw you. So stay tuned tonight. You see, when we hear of crisis, the first thing that comes to mind for you and I is, no. Lord, I don't want this one. When we hear of crisis, a believer going through crisis, the first thing that set in is we begin to ask questions, what have they done? What has she done? God is punishing that person because of what they or we perceive in our mind that person may or may not have done. But we fail to realize that most often than not, it's in the midst of the crisis that you will see the provision hand or the provisional hand of God to deliver you. If you don't go through the crisis, how do you expect to get to the other side or get to the promotion? Because the enemy will fight you till the bitter end. He want to make sure that you do not acquire or receive the blessing of the breakthrough that God has for you. It is on your way to your breakthrough or your promotion, that's when you must go through a crisis. So child of God, I remember a while back, a pastor friend of mine, a close friend, was speaking. I said, you know what, I love crisis. And then he looked at me with a funny eye. He said, what? I said, because in the midst of the crisis, when I'm going through a crisis, I know that there is a breakthrough right on the other side. By experience working with the Lord, whenever I go through a deep and prevailing crisis, I know just at the other end, there is a greater dimension of the breakthrough. If you check the history of any overcomer in the Bible, you will know that they spent time in crisis. But in the midst of the crisis, they trusted the Lord. In the midst of the crisis, they made sure that they give God glory and God the priority. So tonight, I want to talk to somebody. I don't know what crisis you are going through right now, but we are asking that the Lord will take control over Ghana, take control over Liberia, take control over your life. Every champion that I've read of in the Bible, in scripture, he has moved from one form of crisis to the other. Tonight I'm using as my key text, I'm going through the wisdom commentary to bring a point to you. God bless you all so much. Oh, Bishop, thank you for joining. Bishop Sam, God bless you. We give God glory. Thank you tonight for joining us. Every champion, whoever God intends to use, there is some form of crisis that you must go through, but you must trust God that at his word. Remember what Isaiah said. Isaiah said in Isaiah 53, he says, who will believe our report? Isaiah 53 and verse 1. He said, who will believe our report? The report is that God is going to deliver. God is going to set free. God is going to heal. So he was saying that, who will believe our report? Haven't you come to a point in your life yet that you will not magnify the enemy, but you will magnify the Lord? Because he's great. He's mighty. I'm coming to a point in my life that I'm praying that beloved and believers will magnify the things of God. They're magnifying the enemy. We go around and talking about this sickness. We talk about, oh, there is going to be disturbance and there is going to be no peace. There is an election coming. So I'm assuming that there will be struggle. There will be trials. There will be tribulation. Instead of saying that the Bible says, man, peace I give you, not as the world gave. Instead of saying, God says, man, peace passes all understanding. God says he will give his angels that has charge over you. They will minister unto you. I believe we need to get to a point in our lives where we begin to magnify the things of God. Let me stay on text. If you remember Paul, he went from one crisis to another crisis. Shipwreck. People trying to kill him. Facing a jail time. But yet still, he was an overcomer, that he could write that despite all that I'm going through, what is tormenting me, he said, your grace, oh God, is sufficient for me. I pray for somebody tonight that may the grace of God, the supremacy of God, will be sufficient for you no matter what you are going through. The Lord Jesus, he experienced crisis. You see, let me tell you something. The writer of the book I'm using tonight, he quoted something. He says, crisis is always the hinge on the door to promotion. Because when it is set time for you, the enemy will make sure he steps in. Remember Nehemiah. The Bible said the word came to Nehemiah that the walls of Jerusalem were broken down. The gates were broken down. The moment Nehemiah showed up on the scene to rebuild the walls, to put things to place, to make sure your protection is nigh at hand. What happened? Sambalat show up, the agent of the enemy. What happened? Tobiah show up, the agent of the enemy. Geshem show up. In order for you to get your promotion or your breakthrough, you must understand that a crisis will come, but God is going to see you through whatever crisis you are going through. Tonight, I want to speak into somebody's life. Have confidence. The same God from yesterday, he's the same God today. He will be the same God tomorrow. Maybe things are shut up for you. It's okay. keep your focus. Keep your eye upon the Lord. Remind him by his word. Lord, what did you say concerning me? Daniel went through the lion's den, came out. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fire crisis, came out. Job lost everything, came out. Child of God, if God can do that, I just mentioned Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, Job, Sarah went through her own issue. The Bible says when God finally said, a year by this time, that is the Lord speaking to his angels, he says you are going to have a child. The Bible says Sarah stood and laughed. I believe she was laughing in her spirit and saying, oh my God, it's been a long time. I'm looking at the physical attributes of my body and that of my husband. How can I, if I just oppose these two things, it does not add up. There's no way possible at my age and my time. But child of God, that is the word of God that says, as I said, who will we believe our report? So, as you watch different platforms, tonight I'm speaking about Ghana and Liberia, all you hear, let's pray for peace, let's pray for this, there's going to be tribulations, there's going to be trouble. My God, why don't we say there's going to be peace? Why don't we say there's going to be so much peace in the land that people will be astounded at what the Lord will do? Because, listen, Bible says, heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of God cannot. Why? Because he's the one that was in the beginning. Are you here with me? Elijah went through crisis. The brook dried up. God directed him to go and stay there. He was being fed, but the brook dried up. But watch, God did not leave him there. God instructed him. He said, I have already spoken to a widow. Now watch this. The widow food was running out. How can this man go to somewhere where food is running out? But there had to be an obedient part there. When he went there, imagine in our day and age, God gave a word, a proceeding word to a man of God. He said, come and visit this person's house. I've instructed that person to feed you. You get to that person's house and the cupboard is bare. The moment you sit down, the person begins to tell you, say, man of God, I've not been paid for the past year because of COVID-19. What will you think as a child of God? But Bible says, the man of God put that behind. He said, if God can use ravens to feed me, I went through a crisis, but I saw the hand of God move. I want to speak into somebody's life tonight. No matter the crisis you are going through right now, God has already made a provision. The crisis, it's just a hinge on the door of your promotion. Stay with me tonight. We're going to lift up prayer for the people of God. I want to jump now to Luke chapter 5. Reading at verse 1. The Bible says, and it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him, the Lord Jesus, to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret, and two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. 3. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. That is what the Bible says. He says, God told him, the King of Kings, the one that made the seas, the heavens and the earth. He spoke to Simon and said, Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. The Bible says, and Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Oh, praise God. He says, nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Now, child of God, if you are a student of the Bible, you will understand what is happening here. Here is a fisherman. Daytime, you might have heard this before. It is an impossibility to go and catch fish sometimes in the daytime, especially with the archaic things that they used back then with nets and all that stuff, not what these guys have nowadays. Now, they were all done for the night. They hadn't caught anything. I'm sure Peter and his friends were contemplating, what are we going to do next now, Lord? What are we going to do? How are we going to feed our families? Things are shut down. No fish all night. How do I know that? You read in the story, it says, we have toiled all night. We caught nothing. But it says, nevertheless, at that word. Now, I want to ask somebody tonight, how did he confirm this? That whoever was speaking the word has some form of authority to bring to pass that wish was to come to pass. See, sometimes if you are trusting the Lord, something will settle in your spirit that will tell you it will be all right. I hope tonight somebody's getting that. The Spirit of the Lord will settle you. Despite a storm will be raging around you, you have an inner peace. I'm sure when the Lord spoke to Simon, being as experienced as he was, he said, nevertheless, what you have spoken, we'll try it. Can I ask you to try God tonight? I remember one day we were on Sunlight Radio. You might have heard this story. And I was on air with my friend, Reverend Okram from Better House of Prayer in Chicago. And as we were ministering the word, the Lord gave me a word. You see, sometimes if you are not obedient, things will not happen the way God wants it to happen. The Lord gave me a word. I don't usually operate in the word of knowledge or operate in the word of wisdom. But that morning when I heard it clear in my spirit, I spoke it on the air. I said, there is somebody listening to us this morning, Pastor Albert and myself. I said, things are not going as you wanted to. The Lord is saying, do not end it. Do not throw in the towel. Listen to me. As soon as I was obedient and released the word that morning, the enemy stepped in. The station shut down immediately. Pastor Albert can bear me witness. The computer just went down as we were broadcasting. So I rebooted. I called him. I said, Pastor Albert, give me a minute. The station just went down. I'm trying to bring it back up. So as I brought the station back up, I looked on the screen. There was somebody that had repeatedly been calling because we see it. Nevertheless, at your word. And then when we brought the station back up, we started broadcasting. A call came in. And when the call came in, it's not our normal listeners. Our normal listeners are Africans or Liberians or Nigerians or Sierra Leonean. I heard the voice of an African-American lady. And she said, she was almost in tears. She said, I need prayers. I said, what is going on? She said, the word that you just gave was for me. I said, what do you mean? She said, for the past 6 weeks, I just got a job. Every time I turn in my time card, it gets declined. When I turn in the time card for the last 2 weeks, it gets declined. She said, things were not going right for me. Everything is just shutting down on me. So I woke up this morning with the intent that this crisis, I can't take it any longer. I'm about to end my life. On that Sunday morning was what she said. African American lady, now watch. She doesn't know about Sunlight Radio. Has never heard about Sunlight Radio. But she said when she was about to take that step, something spoke to her. I believe the Holy Spirit. It says, she said on the air, I will try to find a recording. She said, call, look for Sunlight Radio. And she was confused. Said, what is Sunlight Radio? African American lady at the word of God in a crisis. But when we were obedient to release the word, God stepped in. She said she went on her computer, look up Sunlight Radio, found the website, and the moment she heard the word that was aligning with her crisis to bring deliverance for her, she said she couldn't hear the station anymore, so she started calling. And praise be to God, when we spoke with her, prayed for her, Pastor Albert was there, she got her deliverance. I believe she's doing well, and God deliver her in crisis at the word of the Lord. Deliverance King, I pray for somebody tonight that may the deliverance of God that came for Simon Peter. As we continue reading the story, the Bible says, and when they had done this, put their net, corresponded to the word of the Lord, the Bible said they got a catch that they needed help for. They couldn't do it by themselves. Remember what I said, a crisis is a hinge to your promotion. As you have gone through COVID-19, can I tell you, child of God, if you are looking for a promotion on the job, but the word of the Lord is coming. If you are looking for divine healing, it's coming. Many of you were looking for educational breakthrough. It is coming. Maybe you were not as strong spiritually as you wanted to be. But through what we have gone through this year, God has given you the strength that you can persevere, that you can pray, that you can share the word of God. You can invite people to program like this to come and watch. You have become an evangelist unknown to you. Listen to me. A crisis is a hinge to your promotion. And I pray for you tonight that just bear it. Stay focused. God is up to something in our lives. In the name of the Lord Jesus. As you continue reading scripture, beloved, you and I will notice that there are scriptures that will encourage you. Scripture that will bring you to a point where you have confidence in God's word. One of those scriptures I love reading, David said in Psalm 37 and verse 25, he says, I have been young. That is David. He says, and now, he says, I am old. Now watch this. What did he say? He says, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, or he says, his seed begging bread. If you can find Psalm 37, if you are at the point where Elijah was, when he went to the widow, and you can say, David said, I have been young, and now I am old. He said, I have not yet seen the righteous forsaken, or his seed begging bread. I pray for that one whose cupboard is bare. I pray tonight for that one whose bank account is gone red. Tonight, at the sound of my voice, I said tonight is power and glory. I pray under the unction of God that may the same God that blessed the work of your hand, the same God that gave seed to the sower and bread to the eater, may he divinely provide your need in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. There's another scripture in Isaiah chapter 12 and verse 2. The prophet writes, he says, surely God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. He said, for the Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. I pray for somebody tonight that whatever you need to be saved from, maybe they have accused you in the court of law. I pray for you tonight. We enter the courtroom of heaven. I pray that the righteous judge, the king that sits enthroned upon the circle of the earth, he will be the one judging your case. I remember so many years ago, the Lord used us to give a word to a friend. Up to today, the Lord has kept her out of prison. And I release that word into your life, that whatever court case they have against you, I seal the docket. I decree and declare that that docket is sealed. It cannot be opened. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I release that word over you, that no lawyer, no judge will open what the Lord has sealed, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. The Bible also says unto you and I, Psalm 33, verse 18. But the eyes of the Lord, Bible says God's eyes are on those who fear him, those that reverence him. Tonight I pray for you, because you reverence the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Almighty Savior. I pray may the eyes of the Lord watch over you. As you go to sleep at night, may the eyes of the Lord watch over you. Pandemic or no pandemic, may the eyes of the Lord watch over you. He says, those who hope is in his unfailing love, God watches over you. Tonight, child of God, remember this crisis is a hinge to your promotion. I'll continue reading. There are so many scriptures. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3. said, thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on him, because we trusted in thee. So now let's pray for Ghana. I pray, Lord, we superimpose peace. I pray whoever intends disaster, may the word that is known as peace envelop them. Lord, when you were in the boat with the disciples, amid the storms, it was you that stood up and declared to the raging storm that you are no longer a storm. I changed your name to peace. And the Bible says it became peace and was still. I speak into the atmosphere over Ghana. I speak into the spiritual realms over Ghana. I speak into the physical realm over Ghana. I speak into the marine world. I speak into the forest region. I speak into the underworld. I speak into the second and third heavens. I decree peace over the land. Lord, they will vote. You will choose that who you want to choose to rule the land of Ghana. I speak over every vessel. Lord, everyone that is imagining destruction over the land, it will not work in the name of Jesus. I speak over Liberia. Come Tuesday, as they go to select senators, I pray for divine peace. The joy of the Lord will be their portion in the name of the Lord Jesus. Because you are a covenant keeping God. Do what you will. One more scripture for you tonight. Isaiah 41 and verse 10. It says, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand. Tonight I pray for somebody that may the Lord hold you up with his victorious right hand in the name of the Lord Jesus. Now I pray for anyone who has gone through this crisis and things are not going right. Bible says he will order the steps of the righteous man, of the righteous woman. I decree over your life tonight that may God cause men to bless you. May your divine helpers locate you tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus. Fear not. Do not be discouraged. God is watching over his word to perform in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Child of God, a crisis is a mere hinge to your promotion. Trust that God will do what he says he will do for you, what he says he will do for me. Peter, Simon at that time said, Lord, I don't know you, I don't know who you are, but there is something in me that says I should obey. Tonight, whatever you find yourself in, as you hear the word of the Lord on Power and Glory Hour, Triumph Worship Show, may God settle your case. May the Lord minister to you. May he draw closer to you as you seek his face. I pray right now, thank you, Holy Spirit, for anyone that has taken seed and is going to hospital upon hospital. I pray, Lord, touch by your grace, by your anointing. I pray for the one that they have spoken over your life, that you have a tumor. Tonight in the hour of power and glory, I speak to the tumor. I pray, Lord, perform divine surgery. Let that tumor shrink now in the name of the Lord Jesus. The one that they have spoken to and said, there is cancer ravaging your body. I decree and declare, by the unction upon my life, I release divine healing upon you. The one that they have spoken and said, you must continue taking insulin because of diabetes. I decree and declare by the voice of Jehovah that let the blood of Jesus that speak better things over your life now in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. I cover you from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. The one with arthritis pain, I speak over your life in this hour of power and glory. I decree and declare right now that let the arthritis subside in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. I speak to the one that they said, as for you, your family goes through this repeated cycle over and over. It is going to be your portion. Remember, Bible says in the book of Galatians 3, beginning at verse 13 down, the Bible says, Christ has redeemed you and I from the curse of the law. Whatever curse that runs in your bloodline from your father to your mother, I revoke tonight. I pray because you are a new creation in the army of God, in the fellowship of God. I speak over your life tonight that whatever ailed your father or ailed your mother or run in the bloodline because they did not know Christ, because you know Christ, I decree and declare unto you that you are no longer to succumb to what run in the patterns of your bloodline. I decree and declare you are beginning a new journey now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, thank you tonight. I speak into every life the amazing God. Show up tonight. Heal. Deliver. Set free. In Jesus' name. Child of God, it's 6:45 tonight. If you are joining me for the first time, my name is Pastor Clarence D. Roberts. I am with the Lord of the Harvest Church International, the House of Glory Temple in Woodbridge, Virginia. You can find us online at www.thelordoftheharvestchurch.org, where we believe that every man, every boy, every girl, every woman will experience liberty, security, and victory by the power of the word. As you enter this week, as we have prayed for Ghana, we have prayed for Liberia, we turn our focus to this nation that we love, America. I pray for the peace of God to reign, the glory of God to be seen. The imagination of men will not prevail, not in this land. I draw a line of demarcation in the realm of the spirit that America will continue to be protected as a nation. No one, no man, no principality, no stronghold. The Bible says that before you can go into the house of a strong man, you must disarm him. And I know from the word of God that my weapon is stronger than any weapon that the strong man has. So I release the finger of God to rewrite whatever they plan. I decree and declare that, Lord, by the blood of Jesus, I release lightning, I release thunder, that my God, you will keep this nation in perfect peace. We give you praise tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus. Our God is an awesome God. We magnify your name, Lord. We thank you tonight. We listen to this song that says, safe in his hands. May Ghana be safe, Liberia be safe, America be safe. Even you, I pray for you tonight, that may you be saved. Honor the protection of Elohim. To all my friends who have joined us tonight, God bless you. Sister Equia from Canada, God bless you. To God be the glory. We just want to thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Thank you for watching over us. You began the year. By February, March, things did not look like it was going to go the way you intended. We have been praying, fasting this week. I want to pray this specific prayer that whatever you have missed, by Habakkuk chapter 2, the vision had tarried. But I'm praying for you that tonight God will compress into the month of December all that you have missed for the past 11 months. I pray that your season of harvest will come to you as you have sown seed. God will compress in the month of December your harvest. May you get an overflow and abundance of grace in Jesus' name. I see my sister-in-law, Dinah Notter. May the Lord settle your case. May the Lord open up for you territories that no man can close. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, may whatever comes round about you, may the angels of the Lord be released tonight to deliver you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. God bless you all so much. I thank God for his grace. I thank God for you supporting this show here on Sunlight Radio, True Room Worship Show. And we thank God that we have been obedient. The same God that delivered Joseph out of the prison into the arena of Pharaoh, may that same God do for you also. Please remember, a crisis is a doorway. A crisis is a hinge. If you understand what a hinge is that which is on your door that will cause it to open and close. This crisis, it is just a hinge that will open the door to where you need to go. Sister Sarah, God bless you. Sister Cynthia, God bless you all. In Jesus' name, may there be a smile coming for you right now. May the Lord put joy on your lips. Wherever you are listening from, I'm sorry, I've been concentrating on those on Facebook. As we go to YouTube now, Mr. Lawrence Milba, that is my Nigerian billionaire. God bless you. Thank you so much. Mr. Sam Nadi, God bless you. Sister Becky Asante, God bless you. Thank you all so much for listening. Sister Quintina Stewart, God bless you. Love you. No bad day. To God be the glory. Reverend Washington Carvey, God bless you. If I can't see your name, it's because it's scrolling by so fast. God bless you all. I just want to acknowledge as many of you that are here tonight. Oh my God, I know there's more of you. Just type your name. Let me see you. Sister Mary Quay, God bless you. Hallelujah. And Brother Isaac Notte, God bless you. All of you who I cannot see, I know you are there. Evans Ofosu, God bless you richly. Hallelujah. 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 I know my apostle, you are listening. God bless you. Apostle Vanderpoel, God bless you. You and your wonderful wife. You know she's October born, so we'll change you to October born as well. God bless you. October born, we are balanced. We are handsome people. Awesome people. God bless you. I know I will get a call from you. God bless you. I see BBG, God bless you. Thank you for joining tonight. Oh God, I pray that may the Lord speak to you. Whatever you need from the Lord, Sister BBG, may the King of Kings that sits enthroned upon the circle of the earth, may he speak to you right now. May he open up his word concerning you. If your heart is troubled, say, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. He goes on to say, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it's a house that you need, God has a mansion already waiting and prepared for you. Stay tuned. Just believe the Lord. A crisis is nothing but a hinge. We are bowing down and worshiping El Elyon, Yahweh, in the name of the Lord Jesus. God bless you so much. To God be the glory. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name, we'll close tonight with, we bow down and we worship Yahweh. You want to bow down in his throne room and worship Yahweh. God bless you. Shalom and shalom. That is peace. Be unto Ghana, Liberia, on this great nation of America. Nevertheless, at your word. If you just put the word of the Lord, make it preeminent in your life, you will see what the hand of God will do. Stay tuned. I've gotten to a point in my life that I believe God above any other person. Even if I see a storm brewing outside and God tells me that the sun is going to come up, I will trust the Lord. That sun will come up. Why? He made the storm. He made the sun. He made the moon. He has the right to orchestrate as he wants. We bow down and worship Yahweh. Hallelujah, we are bowing down in worship. And we're just about to leave tonight. We thank God. But there's a word for somebody. You are still here. Whether you're on Facebook, whether you're on Sunlight Radio, whether you're on YouTube tonight. This is what the Lord says unto you from Jeremiah 1 and verse 19. It says, they will fight against you, but will not overcome you. Say, for I am with you, and I will rescue you, declare the Lord. I heard it for somebody right now. The Bible says in Jeremiah 1 and verse 19, I don't know who you are. He says, they will fight against you, but will not overcome you. For I am with you, and I will rescue you, declares the Lord. Have confidence tonight that the crisis you are going into, the Bible says in Jeremiah 1 and verse 19, whether you're on YouTube, whether you're on Sunlight Radio, whether you are on Facebook, pay close attention to this word. Jeremiah 1 and 19, he said, they will fight against you. I don't know who the they are. He said, but will not overcome you. For I am with you, I will rescue you, says the Lord. I pray tonight for you that whoever you are, whatever that crisis, because we are going through the crisis, the Bible says they are fighting against you, but they will not overcome you. For I am with you, and I will rescue you. Child of God, I want to repeat that word. There is somebody listening to me. I am very, very confident in the fact that when God speaks, He's speaking into somebody's life. Jeremiah 1 and verse 19, to you tonight. Maybe you are the one, you are crying. You say, Lord, how can I make it out of this? I don't know where I'm going to turn. But they have come in against me so many ways. Jeremiah 1 and verse 19. Hold on to that word tonight. It says, they will fight against you, but will not overcome you. Say, for I am with you, I will rescue you. I pray for whoever that person is, whether man, whether woman, the Lord will rescue you. The Lord will deliver you. Remember, I said, I seal the book of that docket. Whatever case they have gone to, whatever they are trying to take from you, by the power of the Holy Ghost tonight, we seal, we overrule, we override. The Lord says, and confirming His word by Jeremiah 1 and verse 19, He said, they will fight against you, but will not overcome you. Have confidence that God has settled that for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we bow down and worship. Now we close with my favorite song. He's too faithful. He's too faithful. Shalom and shalom. And we shall be back next week. I always do that in my closing. Same time, 5:30, here on Sunlight Radio. Pastor Clarence, with all the love. Stay tuned now.
Hallelujah. You are who you are, yesterday, today, and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to disappoint me. You've proven yourself. You're too faithful to fail me. You're too faithful to fail me. Oh Jesus, you're too faithful to disappoint.